Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Josh here, and this is going to be a little kind of an update video in a way where I talk about some of the projects I've been working on for the BitBlock, explain to you why the videos have been a little bit more scarce lately, and also talk about a little bit of drama that's been going on between myself and Lamar Wilson. If you haven't seen it already, we'll go over it. And again, I actually hate doing that in an official YouTube video here because it's like I'm airing my dirty laundry to you guys, and this isn't really something you should, you know, be concerned with or really even want to listen to, because I want the content on the BitBlock to be very, like, professional. But, you know, this is going to be a little update video, so I might as well discuss the drama that has unfolded over the past night. But first of all, let's talk about some fun things. So many of you will remember that I talked about Make Believe, which is a new video series I'm working on, where I'm going to fully illustrate and animate and commentate my ideas for Nintendo's franchises and where they could go in the future. And not just that, excuse me, also going to be talking about like what they can do with controllers and stuff like that. So it's really it's a video series where I kind of make believe what could happen with some of Nintendo's greatest stuff. And they're not real games. I'm not making real games here. It's, you know, just fan art in a way, but it's very elaborate fan art. The first video was obviously delayed because I wanted to put more work into it, and it was more of a mess than I thought it was. When I first started making Make Believe, the first episode, I didn't sit down and tell myself, okay, the first episode is going to be this. This is the theme of the first episode. This is the one thing I'm going to talk about. Instead, the first episode is like 6 or 7 ideas that I'm going to talk about. And moving ahead in the future episodes, they're going to focus on one idea, and that way they'll be able to get out on a pretty frequent basis. You know, I'll be able to upload a new one somewhat frequently. It is a really big undertaking, though. Designing all this stuff is not easy, but it's incredibly fun. I adore doing it, and honestly, it makes me happier with the work that I'm doing. I'm more happy doing this than I have with a lot of stuff, so that's one of the reasons I want to keep doing it. Hopefully when it's done, and it will be done very soon, because it's like literally everything for the first video is done. Now I just have to focus on rendering it and organizing it all in After Effects. So it will be soon. I absolutely promise you that. Hopefully when it's done, it's well received and you guys like it, because I've like poured my heart and soul into this project, and it's been so much work and so much time, but I'm really proud of the way it turned out. So hopefully it'll give you a little smile and you'll like it, and it'll make you wonder what Animal Crossing could be like in the future. So I haven't talked too much about this. Another video feature that I promised was I wanted to play around with the idea of cosplaying as Nintendo characters. I obviously did that with Zero Suit Samus. I did a like gender swap of that, and I had a lot of fun. And I obviously still have the suit and the costume, but that's one of those video features where I didn't necessarily think it out too well, and I don't know if it lends itself to being a video feature. So in the future, if and when I do more Nintendo cosplay stuff, it's probably just going to be a photo shoot, like pictures to share with you guys. The video I did of Zero Suit Samus, or Zero Suit Manus, or Zero Suit Josh, whatever you want to call it, the reaction to that was kind of split in half. There were people that were like really horny for it, and then there were people that were like creeped out by it, and they see something in it that apparently I don't see, because I really don't know why it's creepy, to be honest with you. But yeah, it's either people are really horny for it or uncomfortable watching it. I don't know. But I mean, it's probably because obviously the whole thing, the idea behind those videos actually was they were, the video that I uploaded on YouTube of me in the Zero Suit, that was really just supposed to be animated GIFs. But I was like, well, I've got this HD video and I didn't do anything on YouTube, and I promised there would be videos, so I'll just take the video that I used for the GIFs, put it together in a little compilation, and hopefully it's kind of like eye candy in a way, and it looks like an official movie or something. You know, you can feel free to judge it however you want, but that's why it's there. It wasn't like, I'm not claiming that's like the most brilliant video in the world, but it was hard to pull off. There was a lot of editing done, and the suit was pretty expensive, and getting into the suit is really difficult, and getting out of the suit is even more difficult. But yeah, so in the future, there's going to be photo shoots. I actually plan on doing a photo shoot with the Zero Suit, like a professional one, next month. So where those videos end up, I don't know yet, but obviously you could check on Twitter or Facebook or something, and I'll link. I mean, it'll just be some sort of gallery somewhere. But yeah, I love the idea of dressing up like Nintendo characters. I want to do more. Captain Rainbow, for example. Wonder Red from The Wonderful 101. But yeah, we'll see where that goes. I'm definitely interested in continuing it, but I don't know if a video feature is necessarily the best direction for the cosplay stuff, but we'll see. So let's get to the elephant in the room here. The other night, I was in a really bad mood, really been stressed about doing this make-believe thing and how the first video is just way bigger than I want it to be, and I just want it to be over with so I can see what you guys think of it and just want it to be up there. And just stressed out about other things. I'm moving and stuff, but that's not necessarily an excuse. So last night, well, let's start with this. Lamar Wilson is a YouTuber who sort of specializes in unboxings. Essentially, what this man does is he invites companies, big corporations, to send him free products, and he will open them up in a YouTube video and be very jolly and happy about it. He generally isn't, from what I've seen, he's generally not somebody who puts an opinion out there very often. And maybe that's a good thing. I don't know. That's for you to decide. So for me, somebody who really works his butt off on, I mean, like if you look at the Halloween week episodes of The Fold that we did, and then like look at how many views stuff like that gets. Like our Halloween episodes are like 8,000, 10,000 views. And I'm so fine with that because I predicted that's basically what they would get. But like stuff like that, I put so much work into. So to see other YouTubers literally just unboxing stuff that a corporation sent them, it doesn't sit right with me. I'll be honest. I will fully admit that makes me very envious. It's like you work your butt off to try and do something special, but oh, don't do that. Don't put any work into anything because at the end of the day, all you need to do is open up a bag of Oreos that have a weird flavoring to them, and that's what'll bring in the views. So like, that's really something I've struggled with over like the past 2 years. I think like 2 years ago, I realized that maybe the amount of effort you put into something on YouTube is completely irrelevant, and you really shouldn't put effort into stuff. Like, just filming a shelf of Amiibos when I was at Toys R Us recently was better received than the Halloween week episodes of The Fold that I spent weeks preparing, and look at the set and everything. I mean, you watch those, and you can clearly tell this is passion. This is somebody who cares about making quality content for the people that are watching. And then it's like, you know, you got people like iJustine and Lamar Wilson who literally just exist on YouTube to like shill products. And it annoys me. So what I'm getting at is, people know this. People know that that stuff kind of irritates me a little bit. So friends of mine on Twitter and even on like Facebook and stuff, they'll always link me in like a joking fashion because they agree that, you know, this kind of YouTube content is kind of lame. So they'll link me to it and they'll be like, oh, look what Lamar Wilson got. It's all the Disney Infinity figures. Or, oh, look what Lamar Wilson got. It's the Mega Yarn Yoshi plushie. And so yesterday somebody linked me to the Yarn Yoshi plushie video. I was in a bad mood, stressed out. And I left a comment that was this. I will read the comment verbatim. I don't know if that's a word, but I've heard it before. So anyways, I'll read the comment exactly as I wrote it. And this isn't something I'm necessarily proud of, for the record. So I said, here's a guy that makes a living simply by unboxing things that corporations send him and then painfully faking fake enthusiasm to make viewers feel better about their dull lives. This is why you shouldn't try it, life kids. So, childish. I'll be the first to admit, yeah, I regret saying that, but I'm not going to delete it. I do feel that way. I do really feel that this isn't something people should be content with. Like, you shouldn't be happy with yourself if you're just getting free stuff from corporations and then talking positively about it just because you want more free stuff. I'm not a fan of that, but I'm also not a fan of the fact that I just let my anger and annoyance get to me and I finally left this guy a comment on YouTube. I should be above that. My, you know, totally accept any hatred that people want to send my way for that. He then responds on YouTube in a comment, and it's a pretty lengthy comment, so I'll read it. So he says, and you're one I don't get. You have a great channel of 125,000 subscribers, and you constantly attack me and iJustine. Yes, I've seen the tweets where you don't add me at sign, but you use my name. So first of all, I want to actually point out, that's a little strange, because it's like, if you don't at somebody, I don't think you can, like, you don't see what they're saying. So I think Lamar Wilson is literally going to Twitter and like searching his name to see what people are saying about him. I could be wrong. Maybe you can see what people are saying about you in a different way, but I can't imagine ever searching my name on Twitter just because I'm curious what people are saying about me. That's sort of strange to me. But he goes on to say, bigger channels don't act like this. I'm used to the ones with 3 subscribers doing this, but someone with your numbers, your envy, jealousy, or whatever it is completely out of control. Now, for the record, leaving like 3 sentences or 2 sentences as a comment I don't think that's out of control. What I said was childish and stupid, and I should have never done it because, you know, but saying that it was so bad that it was out of control, I disagree strongly with. It was stupid, but it was hardly some sort of vicious attack. It was me questioning the quality of his content and joking that it means that you shouldn't try at life because trying is the first step towards failure when you could just open up a box of Oreos and overreact to their flavor. He goes on to say, maybe it's your attitude, and maybe it's because they've seen your tweets slamming them and their PR company, which they have, by the way. You've ensured that they will never work with you. So he's talking about Nintendo of America. If you follow me on Twitter, you'll know that I'm not shy to call out Nintendo of America or their PR company when I feel that they're doing wrong. I value having my own voice and having my own opinion and being passionate about something more than I do getting free plastic from Nintendo. I have always been very appreciative towards what they send, and I always cover the products they send, and I think, even though, like, Chibi-Robo Ziplash, I think that game is garbage, but if you watch the review I did for Chibi-Robo Ziplash, the official content that I put out there to the audience, I was very fair to the game. I didn't take any cheap shots. I very clearly said that I didn't really enjoy it, but I even said that it could be recommendable to a certain audience and blah, blah, blah. So, you know, Lamar, I'm more interested in having an opinion than I am having people at Nintendo love me. I don't get it. I've done and said nothing to you. I don't even know you, and you keep attacking me. Are you racist? We'll get to that in a minute. I have no idea why he decided to go that route. He says, is your hate that bad for somebody who's just trying to be successful? Just because I have a fan base doesn't mean I'm fake. I've had a hard life. This is the real me. Also, you make a living playing and reviewing games. How is that so different from what I do? You're not insulting me. Okay, so a couple things. Pulling the race card is, like, beyond ridiculous. So anybody who questions Lamar Wilson's quality of content is apparently a racist. Again, there's nothing I can say about that other than it's ridiculous. And then he says, first of all, I will say, he's right. He's done nothing to me, and he's said nothing to me. Therefore, it absolutely is stupid and childish of me to attack him in this way. Like, you're absolutely right about that, Lamar Wilson. I apologize. You've never attacked me. I was stupid to say something. I'm human. I was in a bad mood. I was stressed out amongst a lot of things. I'd done wrong. So I apologize for that. And then he goes on to say he's had a hard life. Yeah, we've all had hard lives, but I'm not going to get into that. He says that I make a living reviewing games. How is that different from what he does? The difference is in the content. I mean, if you look at the BitBlox content and you compare it to the unboxing videos that Lamar does, I think it's clear what the difference is. The difference is I spend painstaking hours writing a review, getting the footage for a review, putting the review together, having an opinion on the game. That's a lot of work. That's tons of work. I don't just open the games up. There's something else I want to point out before I forget. I've seen some of Lamar's videos. I've seen a decent amount of them. And in one of his videos, which was completely unrelated to this game, he casually mentions that Nintendo sent him The Legend of Zelda Triforce Heroes, but he hasn't really had a lot of time to play it and blah, blah, blah. And this was like, he says that he's had it for like at least a week. This is annoying to me for a lot of reasons. First of all, when you get content from Nintendo or any game developer, you're supposed to look at that as being a huge privilege and that it's a job. That review copy is a job for you. You have to cover it. You have to talk about that game. You can't just casually say, oh, by the way, I've had this so-and-so game for a week and I haven't had a lot of time to play it. That's so lousy. You're supposed to cover the game. And the reason that upsets me is not even for me. It's not even because I'm working hard to cover the games that Nintendo sends, but it's for the little sites out there, the little channels who want Nintendo to send them review copies, but they can't get Nintendo to send them review copies, Lamar. So, like, for example, there's this really great guy who's starting out. I've known him for a few years. His YouTube is Bradley Cragen, Bradley News 11. He's starting out a Nintendo channel. He wants to review Nintendo games. He doesn't always get a lot of reviews from Nintendo. And the reason is because Nintendo's busy sending review copies to people that are just going to casually mention that they have the game. It literally frustrates me to no end to see all these great younger people wanting to start out, wanting to get into game journalism, wanting to talk about games, really wanting to get review copies to have that edge to be able to talk about a game before it comes out, because that can help them in their popularity. And they don't get it because people like Lamar Wilson are busy getting everything from Nintendo. That's bullcrap. Bradley and many others deserve the stuff that Lamar gets because they would actually spend the time to review the game. They would know what a privilege and how exciting it is to have The Legend of Zelda Triforce Heroes a week in advance or whatever. And they would take that week to really play the game, to really form an opinion, to review it, to talk about it, and genuinely promote the game in a real way. Lamar finishes by saying, "I'm not mad at all. I'm just surprised that your anger has finally caused this moment to happen. Why do you choose to even acknowledge I exist? There are thousands of channels. Just move on. Envy is a killer. It eats you up, and it'll destroy you in the inside and eventually your channel. Which is a shame. You seem like a nice guy. At least that's what you portray, and you have a cool channel. Anyways, take care." So here's the deal. In that last comment where he says, "You seem like a nice guy, nice channel, all that stuff," it would have more weight to it if he didn't then turn around, take a screenshot of this YouTube comment and tweet it out in an effort to get all of his fans to essentially harass me, which is what they've been doing for pretty much the past, I don't know, 18 hours or so. It's not been quite a day yet. I did this last night. So if you were taking the high road, Lamar, if you were the bigger person here, you would have just responded to me on YouTube and left it at that. And I would have responded to you and I would have said, "Yeah, you know what? I was out of line. You're right. I apologize. I don't agree with the content that you make. I don't get it. I don't think it's really hard work, but you do your thing. I'll do my thing." Instead, Lamar clearly had a motivation behind this. I think Lamar loved the fact that I said this because he knows like, "Oh, the BitBlock people know what that is. That's got some popularity to it. I'm going to tweet out that Josh said this, and then that's going to get people to bash him and harass him." He knew what he was doing. He even in the tweet, oh, by the way, I should say his tweet says, "Hey, at the BitBlock, I saw your comment attacking me on my channel. I wrote a response. I'm sorry you're upset." Well, you're not sorry I'm upset, obviously. And then he tagged Justine, I think I Justine is pretty much one of the worst YouTubers out there, if I'm being totally honest. She's another one who's just wanting companies to send her stuff. She'll talk about them, and that's what she does for a living. She unboxes things for a living. And you know what? I know that I do unboxings here as well, but they're few and far between. I don't do a lot of unboxings here. And when I do them, even in the videos, I think I start off by saying like, "Yeah, this isn't the most entertaining thing in the world," but I do them because Nintendo sent the product, and usually if the product has something in it, like an amiibo or whatever, or an accessory, I'll unbox it just to show the amiibo or just to show the accessory. Not proud of the unboxings, but some people are like, "Oh, Josh, you're a hypocrite because your channel does nothing but unboxings as well." What? The BitBlock has so much content that clearly has so much work put into it. I don't do unboxings as the main thing. They're like maybe not even 20% of what the BitBlock does. And he's also tagged Game Explain, which is really weird. I don't know why he would do that. Game Explain has nothing to do with this. And he tagged Nintendo of America. So Game Explain and Nintendo of America being tagged in his tweet where he calls me out is very interesting to me, because it's essentially Lamar saying, "This guy is calling me out. This guy is saying he doesn't like what I do. I'm going to take this guy down by telling Game Explain about this and telling Nintendo of America about this." In his mind, he thinks Game Explain isn't going to want to talk to me anymore because of this. Like, he doesn't want Game Explain to talk to me. I'm not going to, you know what? I appreciate and respect Andre and everybody at Game Explain enough to not drag them into something that they're not even involved with. I'm not going to bring Andre into this and let him deal with this nonsense. He has nothing to do with it. Lamar Wilson, on the other hand, is okay with dragging Andre and Game Explain into this for no reason other than he thinks it's going to make Andre not want to talk to me or something. I don't know. And then he clearly tagged Nintendo of America because he wants Nintendo of America to stop doing any kind of business with me. Even though they're sending me stuff, and I truly appreciate every single thing Nintendo has ever sent me, I treat it as a job. It's an agreement. It's me saying, "Okay, this is your game. You sent it to me. Thank you very much. I'm going to play it, and I'm going to give my audience my honest opinion on what I think about it." Because at the end of the day, to me, that's what it's all about. It's about the audience, the people who watch the BitBlock's content. And I know this is going to sound like I'm getting up on my pedestal or soapbox or whatever, but I am well aware that the people that are listening to this drivel right now are the reason that I get to do the amazing stuff I get to do. This make-believe video where I'm pouring my heart and soul into it, trying to develop a cool Wii U version of Animal Crossing, it's fake, but, you know, just like a cool little video. Those are the people that will watch that are the reason I'm doing it. Because at the end of the day, that's what it's about, man. It's about the audience and it's about the people who watch you, and they deserve better than you treating your audience like they're just bullets to be fired at me. Because that's what you're doing. That's why you tweeted it. You tweeted this because you knew all the people that follow you would then harass me and say, oh, this guy's an idiot. Oh, this guy's content sucks. Oh, this guy's jealous and envious. Jealousy and envious is not necessarily the right words, but you're on the right track. It is hard to work your butt off at something and really, really get in there and put some passion into it and put a lot of hours into it. And then you put it up and there's somebody else next to you that's opening up a box of cinnamon flavored Doritos and making screeching noises, and that person's getting more attention. Yeah. And you know what? I would not even have a problem with the fact that there's these YouTube channels out there that just exist to unbox things. Like, that's not even really the problem that I necessarily have. One of the problems that I have is when these YouTube personalities will put, like, an email for business inquiries in the description or on their Twitter. Like, on their Twitter, they'll have, like, oh, if you want to do business with me, here's my business email. That's literally them saying, hey, I'm a complete shill. I don't really care to have a personality or an opinion. So if you're a big corporation or a company that wants me to advertise your product, send it to me for free and I'll open it up for my audience. It's really weird. It's almost like I value the quality of content and hard work more than I value being buddy-buddy with Nintendo. Think about that, Lamar.